Hello students, welcome to the another lecture based on LPC 2 14. In this lecture, we are going to study LCD interfacing with LPC 2 14. So, the aim of the program. The aim of the program is to interface 16 by 2 liquid crystal display, that is LCD to LPC 2 14. Here, we are going to use port 0 for interfacing. So, the registers which will be used for the programming are pin cell 0, that is pin function select register, which will set the pins as GPIO. Next is IODIR, it's a input output direction register, which will set the direction of the port pins as a input or output. IO set and IO clear, these registers are used to set or clear individual bits or group of bits for port 0, and IO pin 0 to set the data collectively to different pins of port 0, or to read the data collectively from the pins, you are using the IO pin register. So these five registers we are going to use for the programming. Now let us start with the fundamentals of LCD, that is liquid crystal display, for the programming. So here we are going to use basically 16 by 2 LCD. What do you mean by 16 by 2? So in this window, this is a window shown here. In this window, you can see that in one line, you can write 16 different characters. Therefore, this is called as 16. Okay. So 16 columns are present here and such two lines are present. So basically, we are going to interface 16 by 2 LCD, 16 columns per line and such two lines are present. Okay. Then, this is the pins given for the LCD. So, first is a VSS ground pin. Second is a VCC plus 5 supply pin. VEE contrast control, which is used to, which is actually connected to the port. This port will help us to adjust the contrast for the backlight and the your letters. Then three control pins are present there: register select, read write and enable. These three pins are actually useful to send data or instructions to the LCD. Then data lines are present D0 to D7, that is data pin 0 to data pin 7, where we can send 8-bit instruction or data actually to the LCD, or we can read the data from LCD by using these lines. LED plus and LED minus, these are again used for illumination of the backlight. You are using this these two pins. Okay, so we will study in detail. Pin number 1 is a ground. This is connected to the ground of the microcontroller power source. Pin number 2 is the VCC. It is connected to the supply pin of the power source. Pin number 3 is the adjust the contrast of the LCD. This is connected to a variable port that can be sourced by 0 to 5 volt. Pin number 4 is register select. This is actually used to toggle between command and data. So when 0, it is command mode. And 1, it is data mode. Okay. Next, pin number 6 is enable. This is, it must be held high to perform read or write operation. Means you have to make it from low to high, you have to connect it, and again you have to make it high to low. Okay. So you have to give the pulse at the enable pin for either any of the read and write operation. That may be your data writing or command writing. Next, data bits 0 to 7. These pins are used to send the command or data to the LCD. Okay, one additional thing I want to tell you about this. Here you can use it in 8-wire mode. 8-wire mode means all 8 pins are used to connect the microcontroller. Means you can use 8 pins to send the data. But in some cases, you can use it in 4-wire mode also, where you can save the number of pins. If you want to save the number of pins, you can use 4-wire mode also. We will discuss this mode afterwards. Now, next is pin number 15. It is LED positive. normal LED like operation to eliminate the LCD. It should be connected to plus 5 volt. Normal LED like operation, it should be connected to the ground. So to eliminate LCD, you have to connect pin number 15 to VCC and pin number 16 to the ground. So this is a pin description for the LCD we have seen. Then another important point about the LCD is the commands. We are giving common commands for working of the LCD. So data means whatever the actual text you want to display there, and command means what to do is given, the instructions are given to the LCD. So these are some typical commands and their meanings are given here. 0F, it is LCD on, cursor on. 01, clear display screen. 02, return home. 04, decrement cursor, that is shift cursor to left. 06, increment cursor, shift cursor to the right. 05, shift display right. 07, shift display left. 0E, display on, cursor blinking. 80, force cursor to beginning of the first line. C0, force cursor to beginning of second line. 38, two lines and 5x7 matrix, that is 16x2 LCD display, and your normal 5x7 matrix is there. 83, it's a cursor, line 1, position 3. 3C, activate second line. 08, display of cursor of C1, jump to second line, position 1. 0C, display on, cursor of C1, jump to second line, position 1. C2, jump to second line, position 2. 32, this is also important, 16x2 LCD, 4-bit mode of interfacing. 28 is also used for 16x2 LCD, 4-bit mode interfacing. This is the interfacing diagram for the LCD. Now see carefully that we have used port 0 here. P0.4 is connected to the RS. P0.5 is connected to the RW read-write signal. And P0.6 is connected to the enable signal. This is very important when you are going to write the program. RS, RW and enable are connected to 4, 5 and 6 pins respectively. Then from pin number 8 to pin number 15, these 8 pins are connected to D0 to D7. Okay. Next, we are going to the actual program. So, you know that when you are writing the C program, the very first statement is to initialize it with header file for the LPC2148. Then, in general, this is again a regular practice. You should always use delay routine at the beginning of the program. You can use it anywhere in the program. So this is simple C delay routine used to create a delay. Here you can see that it is unsigned integer B is used. Remember, this is very important. Why? Because it is going to decide the length of the data or range of the B number, that B variable is decided by this unsigned integer. Okay. So to increase the range, you are using this unsigned integer. If you use character, it will be 255 only. So be careful about what type of the data type you are giving for this variable B. Okay. So unsigned integer means it is 65536. So you can use here 10,000. Next, when we are going to interface LCD with controller, you have to use two routines there. One is the command and second is the data. For that, here we are defining two functions. One is the command write, second is the data write. So if you remember the pin diagram here, pin number 4, 5 and 6 are connected to RS, RW and enable. The same thing here we are going to use for command write. So RS is P0.4. Okay. So for command write, we have to make RS is equal to 0. So the sequence of the any for giving command is give the command, that is RS, then read write, and then enable high to low transition, and then you have to send the data there. First you put the data and then give the enable command. Okay, this is the sequence for giving the command. Same thing is done here. IO clear 0 is equal to 1 left shifted by 4, means it will become 10000. So P0.4 pin is cleared. Similarly, we have to make read write pin also 0. So I'm doing 1 left shifted by 5 is sent to IO clear 0, means that bit will be cleared. So this bit is also cleared, this bit is also cleared. So for command P0.4 is made 0, for read write P0.5 is made 0, it means it is write operation. Next, we want to send the data. So that, what is the data? Data is the character which we are going to pass. This is the argument pass to this function. So what we are having, this is the argument we are passing there. Okay, so this A is taken here first and it is ended with FF, means rest all other pins are made 0 because this is 8-bit data, and then we have to convert it into 32-bit. So what we have made, last 8 bits are kept as it is and remaining all bits are made 0 first. Okay, then it is left shifted by 8. Why left shifted by 8? Because we want to send the data to these 4 pins, 8 to 15, not 0 to 7. It means we have to left shift it by 8. Okay, so left shift operation is performed here. So this is the first operation, masking. This is the second operation, left shift by 8. And this is the third operation, we are ending with IO pin 0, means we are not modifying other pins. We are modifying only these pins. Remember, for that, this OR operation is used. Okay, remember, OR operation is only used to modify particular pins of IO pin. Okay, pin number 8 to 15 are modified here. And then remaining is make the pulse. Here we are giving one pulse at enable pin. Okay. First we are making it high and then we are making it low. So this function is used to send the command to the LCD. Make RS is equal to 0, make read write is equal to 0, send the data to the port pins and make the enable pin high and low, that is give the pulse there. Okay. Now when we go for next function, it is data write. In case of data write, what will be the difference? There is only one difference. Instead of making this P0.40, we have to make it 1. So here, instead of having it clear, it will be set. Only that is the difference. Rest all other things are same here. So this is the data write function I have written here. So IO set 0 means it will make P0.4 bit 1 here. Okay. Remaining things are same. The rest of the sequence is same for LCD interfacing data write. Okay. So this is a function used to send the data to the LCD. Now, initialization. We have seen some codes, commands for the LCD. Out of that, we are going to use a few commands. So the first one is 1038. So what it will do? This function will be called command write, and here it will pass 38. Okay. So now here 38 command is given. What do you mean by 38? So it is nothing but 16 by 2 LCD, 8 bit mode we are selecting. Next is 0E, display on cursor blinking, 01, clear display screen, 06, increment cursor, that is shift cursor to the right, 080, force cursor to the beginning of the first line. So these 5 commands are compulsorily given for the initialization of the LCD. So here we have made another function there. We have directly declared the function. We will only call this function in the main program. So this is the actual main program, starts here. Okay. And here first part we have declared is one string. the string which we want to display on the LCD that we have declared here, str1 welcome. Then one variable we need, so we will need that somewhere. So for that one variable j is declared. Next is a pincel 0. This is used to set the GPIO for the port pin. Here we are not using that port for any other purpose. We are going to use it for general purpose input output. So for that we are making the pin cell register 0 here. Okay, next is the IODIR 0. We are making all the pins F means 1. 1 means we are making it output. Okay, to set it as the output, we are making all the pins output pins. So for that we are sending FFFFFF to the IODIR0. We are making port 0 as output port. Okay, next is LCD initialization. We have seen this function. We are giving different commands there to the LCD, like 38, 0E, 01, 06 and 80. These commands are given in the LCD initialization. And then what we are doing? While str1. What is str1? Do you remember? We have written there one string. That string was welcome. Okay. So this welcome string we are going to pass to the LCD one by one. Okay. So for that, what we have done? We have written the while loop. What is while loop does? Actually, your last letter in your string is always 0, that is blank. Okay, so unless it is not becoming 0, it will perform the task which is given in this while loop. Okay, so what it will do? It will first send data_write str1 of j. J we have declared in it as first 0. So it will first send w. That is j is equal to str1 of 0 will be w. Then it will increment j. So now it will point to the e. So it will send e. Okay. Then l, like that. And up to e, it will go on sending character by character the string to the LCD. Okay. Now when it will stop? It will stop when it encounters 0. Okay. So when it encounters 0, this condition is false and it will come out of that. So this is the simple way of sending the string whose length is unknown. You don't have to every time remember the length of the string which you want to use in your program. Okay, you can use while loop for unknown length of the string. So for that, this is it. So this is all about the program of the LCD. Here, this is LCD 16x2. Here it will display welcome there. You can observe this in the Proteus also. You just enter the code there and you will get the output of this program. So thank you, students. Thank you once again.